Hello, good afternoon everybody. I am Dr. Abhishek Soni. I am here again with the lectures of Basic Mechanical Engineering of second semester. And you might be remembering that I have left my discussion with the arithmetic and statistical averages in the last lecture, and I have given the numericals to solve. And I do hope you might have solved the numericals based on all the arithmetic averages formulas. You might have finded out the arithmetic mean, geometric mean, as well as average deviation, dispersion, standard deviation, and the variances of the numericals that I have given to you. Now, in the coming part of the measurement unit that we were discussing, I am moving ahead with my few short lectures, and I will be covering up those topics in subsequent lectures, and we will be finishing up this unit very quickly. And you please concentrate on the discussion that I am doing with you, and if possible, I will take the help of the blackboard, that is small blackboard that is available with me. Since there is little bit problem there, so I am just taking the lecture here. So as the problem will be sorted out, I will be taking the lecture on the blackboard, and we will be taking the numerical to solve this. So the topic that I will be taking today is transducer. Since I am discussing in very slowly, so you can easily understand what I want to explain, and you will be easily understood. And if you go through the topic through the book that is with you, so you will be easily to understand. So in the unit of measurement, we have discussed till the arithmetic averages, and now we are moving over to the topic of transducer. So a transducer, you can just understand, it is a device in a most general form that converts one form of energy into another form for the purpose of measurement. Theek hai, so a transducer may be defined as, in its most general form, as a device that converts energy from one form to another form for the purpose of measurement. A transducer is a device which, when actuated by energy in one transmission system and supplies energy in the same form or in another form to the second transmission system, this energy transmission may be electrical, mechanical, chemical, optical, as well as thermal. So you understood what is a transducer. A simple definition is, it's a device that converts one form of energy into another form for the purpose of measurement. Now we are moving over to the classification of the transducer. So transducer may be classified very broadly. So I am going through one by one, and you just listen up what are the basis of the classification of transducer. So a transducer may be classified on the base of the transduction form, that is, it may be a resistive, a capacitive, inductive, as well as piezoelectric, as well as thermoelectric or optical, its effect, transduction effect. This is one classification of the transducer. Second is primary and secondary transducer. The Bowden tube acting as a primary detector senses the pressure and converts pressure into displacement at its free end. The LVDT is called secondary transducer. Okay. So I have explained to you in my lectures that what is Bowden tube pressure gauge. It senses the displacement, it senses the change of pressure at one end and converts into the displacement at the free end. So it is a passive, it is not requiring any secondary power source. But linear variable differential transformer, it requires a power source, that's why it is a secondary transducer. So second one was one requiring the external power source. So one which is not requiring is primary, and one which is requiring external power source is a secondary transducer. Third one is active and passive transducers. Passive transducers derive the power source from the passive transducer derive the power source from the transduction form and auxiliary source. They are known as external power transducers. Active transducers, they do not require any auxiliary power source to produce the output. So they are also known as self-generating type of transducer. So active transducers and passive transducers, primary transducers and secondary transducers, and also based on the transduction effect. Next one is analog and digital transducers. The analog transducers are those that convert the input quantity into an analog output. A strain gauge, an LVDT, a thermocouple may be known as an analog transducer. Digital transducers converts the input quantity is in the form of pulses. ठीक है? Next classification is a transducer and inverse transducer. So a transducer can be devised as a device which converts a non-electrical quantity into electrical quantity, and vice versa is the inverse transducer. So this was the classification of the transducer. In the next lecture, we will go for strain gauges, and we will derive the sensitivity of the strain gauge, that is the gauge factor. Okay? So I will be taking in the next lecture. So till then, remain safe.